It's Lynda Cromar, and I'm coming to you again from Colorado. And this is my Facebook profile so that you can find me if you'd like to connect with me further. And also, I will be sharing that again. If I can get this to work. There we are. All right. I hope everybody's having an awesome day today. And thank you for coming. Hello, everyone. And thanks for the hearts already. Wow. But I've got some great tips again. I like to give you some value. I don't know about you, but whenever I see people that just come on and say, hello, how are you? Well, I mean, you know, people are busy. They really, truly want to have good value brought to them. So I'm going to share some things. But one thing also, have fun with it. So how do we do that? How do we make it fun? For one thing, this is interactive. You know, this is not just I'm going to give you a lecture and I don't want to talk to you. That's not very much fun for most people. And you want to make sure that they love it. So am I chatting? No, I'm actually sharing with you some product, some different things that you can do. So anyway, one thing I've noticed when I've been watching scopes is that sometimes people are not actually ready to do it. They kind of hem and haw. One really quick tip is write it down. Write down what you want to say. You just have little bullet points that will help you out so that you don't feel like you have to hem and haw. You know, that's kind of normal. We do that if we're not really sure. And if you do have, you know, a little bit, I have a bullet list here to help me. Hello, everyone. Thanks for coming. And I have a bullet list of what I want to share with you so that I can help you the most and also keep this on point so it's not going to drag on, because nobody wants to spend 50 minutes and you just barely get to the topic at the very end. So you want to prepare. So then also have a topic picked and use it and look around in the people that you're connecting with that you truly want to help, and what kinds of things they're actually looking for in the way of information. Yeah, that can happen. They do sometimes exploit it a little bit. But you know what? You and I are not celebrities. So hello, everyone that's now just now joining. Yeah, we're not celebrities, so we're not going to have that advantage, right? So anyway, you want to know something about the topic that you're actually going to use. I mean, is it actually relevant to the audience that you want to talk to? Is it something that is going to be a benefit to your audience? Because if you think about it, it needs to be of a benefit to your audience. It's not about you at all. It's about them, right? So you have that topic, you have a benefit in mind, and it's not necessarily about they have to join that day, because as you know, it has to have some people have to join you because they've grown to like you, and especially that they've grown to trust you. Well, that's kind of off subject. No, we don't need to have lightning. And you know, one thing also I noticed, there's different personalities, of course. But you don't have to be stuffy. I don't know whether you've noticed or not, but the community and the kind of the flavor of Periscope in particular is kind of laid back, kind of having fun, kind of just on the spur, and not so much about being so polished. You don't have to be polished. And I think that's particularly kind of helpful and happy to know that, you know, anybody that has not actually been on any kind of other video format can actually do well here, because if you care about people enough to find out a little bit about what it is they're really interested in, finding out more about it, and then get, you know, get brushed up on it so that you can understand where they're coming from, and then from there, give them some real value. And then you don't have to be stuffy. I'm not stuffy. I'm pretty laid back, but I'm down to earth too. I don't try to do hypey stuff. I think that's kind of boring. And of course, it's a turnoff to me, so I don't do it for anybody else. Now, to keep it fun, you can do things like asking questions. Like I haven't asked, and we got 22 people in the room now. Where are you all coming from today? What state or country are you in? And go ahead and comment. Everybody comment on, okay, Colorado. Yay, Colorado. There's a Colorado in the house. Memphis, Tennessee. Hoo-hoo, Canada, California. That's awesome. Alaska, Oregon, Texas, Philly. Very cool. Okay, so when people have something where they get to answer a question like I just did, that's always making them feel like they're part of the conversation, and that's really important because when you can make them part of the conversation, they feel like it's part kind of belongs to them. They're likely to stay a lot longer if you include them. And thanks so much for the hearts. I also want to recommend that you can connect with me. I'll show you at the end how you can do that. You want to take the time to figure out where people are coming from, and I don't mean their state necessarily, but what their needs are and what they need to find out about. Most of the time, if you're so worried about telling them about your company or product, you're not really looking at what their needs are. South Carolina, awesome. Very cool. Anyway, you want to make sure their needs are met. And if you meet their needs, I can promise you they will be more likely to be interested in what you have to share. And you take the time to build that rapport until the time comes that they want to be your customer. But that won't happen on the very, very first contact. Yay, Virginia, thanks for coming. Okay, and you want to ask about them. Ask about what they are doing and what is the results of what they've done so far. Yeah, you can absolutely request topics for your followers if you're not sure. Find it. That's in your question and answer part. You can even do a whole Periscope that's just question and answers. Yay, Arkansas, welcome. You can also ask them, are they getting any value? Or is there something that you need to cover differently so that they get what you're trying to explain to them? Like if somebody's particularly new at Periscope, and for instance, I love it when you give me hearts. Do you know how to give hearts? You just tap, tap, tap on the screen, and that's how you give hearts. And I love people that give hearts. I make sure and follow them if I haven't already. And so that's one thing you can do is explain things, ask them questions, find out where they're at, and find out if they understand what you're giving them. Or if you're talking too much in a lingo that they don't understand, maybe you need to tone it down to more of a not dumb, I don't mean dumb, but make sure that you're not using industry language when you're talking to people that are not actually in your industry. For instance, I had some, conversations in Facebook talking about customers in particular. And obviously, what you're looking for when you're on Periscope, if you're a marketer like I am, you want customers, right? You want customers for your product. So how do you get those customers? For one thing, you care about them enough that you bring them to, the information that they are looking for, and you ask them questions. I don't know about you. Most of you probably have a Facebook account. And how do you like it when somebody chats at you at the very beginning and says, "Here's my company, here's my link, go join it now." Do you love that or not love that? I bet you nobody loves that. I don't, yeah, feedback. I don't. Yes, absolutely. You don't, and I don't. Because what is happening in that experience is that you feel like I don't matter, right? You feel like you don't matter because do I use a tripod? Absolutely. That's what I'm using right now. Yeah, I feel like I don't matter to that person because they never even asked me one question. Not even are you even open for that? Hey, Kim from Texas, welcome. And also, you want to show them why they should be interested in what you have. And the way you do that is to ask questions. You got to ask them what they think. So those people that do the chat messages, and I hope none of you here are one of those, but it never works. Even if you are already friends with somebody and you just suddenly send them a message that's all about your company, it doesn't matter how much you love it, it doesn't matter how good the product is, it never gets them that excited about being in there. And so what do you do when you have a customer and you have a problem? I'm really going to cover some other bases here too. When you have a customer and you have a problem, like in my case, I was a customer to somebody else, and I asked them what was going on with the product because it wasn't getting sent to me. And you know what? The only thing she would do is just keep telling me it's on back order, it's on back order. Well, 3 months later, I finally contacted the company directly, and I told them her name because it was really her responsibility to respond to me as her customer. And that is something you never want to do. You want to always respond directly to your customer, whatever company you're in. Yeah, it is good grief. You want to take good care of that customer because guess what happens if you make them unhappy? I went and asked them for a refund, so then she'll never get me as a customer. And when you lose a customer, it's harder to get new ones than it is to just make the one you have happy. And how hard would that be to figure out a way to get that product to that person? Not really. There is a way. And I would have bent over backwards, or I would have ended up giving a refund if that was necessary or the only other option. But don't leave them hanging. It's not worth it to leave your customers hanging. And guess what they'll do? They'll go and talk about how badly they were treated, and that hurts you too. So you don't want that. Tell them how to connect with you. That's the last point and the major, most important one. If you are in live with them, then you make sure they have your business card. But what about on the web? For instance, my best way to tell you how to connect with me is on the Facebook because I'm always there and it's easy to, yes, build a relationship. It's really easy because usually when I connect with somebody, they're not particularly ready to become my customer that very day. But I want them to connect with me so they get another opportunity to learn what I do and to learn how it would benefit them. Now, notice I'm saying benefit a lot. Reason why is because the bottom line really is that customer's benefit, whether or not it's going to benefit them and whether or not it's going to be what they need for whatever they're doing. So, absolutely give them a way that they can connect with you and not necessarily the company website. That is not the best way for them to connect with you. The best way is probably either your business card if you're offline or your social media contact areas on the net. Like Facebook is a really simple and easy way because it has the chat and various different ways that you can have more conversation, talk to them more. I mean, I've had several that have joined me in my Facebook friends as just coming off of one of these Periscopes, and I'm going to invite you guys that are on here today to do exactly the same thing, is to come to my Facebook, and I'm going to show that to you now because now we're done. Unless you got some questions, do you have some questions about what I covered today? And you can always go back to the replay because I packed a bunch of information into that because I believe in giving you lots and lots of value. So, first of all, let's get back up to the top of my Facebook. Okay, why is it not going up? Here we go. It doesn't want to let me get there. It's flashing. Let's see. Well, anyway, my Facebook, I'm going to just flash right in. Oh, I got to flash right into the Facebook Right there is my profile. I will absolutely accept your friend's request if you are just going to give me a message just saying, "Hey, I was on your Periscope and I'm connecting with you on your Facebook and that's all you have to do to connect with me." And also number two, I also have, let's get over here. Well, you may not be able to get there. I also have a lot of opportunities for you to get on my email list with free offers, like some PDFs of some really good information. And that's on my about page. And so I hope that everybody has gotten value. Please let me know. And we'll be talking probably tomorrow.